Once the hard disk file is downloaded, we'll have to next process and upload the VHD file to the Azure Stack HCI cluster. To do that, we have to run a couple of PowerShell commands. This is the path to the VHD file which we just got downloaded. New path, changing the file extension to Vhtx. Parameter VHD type as dynamic. Now you can see the conversion has started and it'll take a few minutes. Once the conversion is complete, we'll have to run the optimize VHD command. This time, it'll be the new Windows VHDX file. The next step is to copy the VHDX file to the Azure Stack storage, which is residing on-premise. To do that, we have to open the Windows Admin Center and select the cluster. Under our cluster, we'll have to click on Volumes, Inventory, and we already have a cluster storage ready for us. We need to click on that. Click on the file location. And under C drive, we'll have something called as cluster storage and a folder by name for VHDX. This is one which we have created for ourselves. We need to click on upload and we need to select the virtual hard disk file which we just downloaded or converted. So this will take some time. Once the virtual hard disk is successfully uploaded to the cluster storage, we'll have to next create the virtual machine by attaching this virtual hard disk. To do that, let's click on Windows Admin Center, choose our cluster, and under that, let's select virtual machines. Let's click on Add and New. And under Storage, let's click on Add and select the option as Use an existing virtual hard disk. In the Path window, let's provide the path to the cluster storage and the virtual hard disk. So this is the virtual hard disk which we just uploaded. Let's select that and click OK. With all set, let's click on Create to create the virtual machine. The virtual machine will be in a power off state. We need to turn it on. Once the virtual machine is created with the virtual hard disk, we can do things like attaching this system to the domain. Once it's successfully joined to the domain, we can connect to the system and log in. So this is the Windows 11 machine which we just created and attached it to the virtual machine. At this point, you can install any custom software from your organizations.